Y ahora, and welcome to Living Life as Easy As with Happiness. Happiness, happiness, happiness. That's what we're going to be talking about today, happiness. But first, before we get going, I just want to say I'm really, really sorry about the background noise that you're going to be hearing. I live beside an extremely busy road, but I really wanted to film from here today because I just want to share with you something that makes me really, really happy. And that means I need to be sitting here today. So yeah, I'm really, really sorry about the background noise, and I'll keep the video short because of the noise. It's not going to be very good quality, but just to get the message across. First of all though, can I just say a huge, huge shout out to a gorgeous young man, Shion Noble. He is one of my biggest fans. He's always contacting me and telling me amazing things, and he's really appreciating the stuff that he's hearing. So Shy, thank you so much for your support and for being in my corner. You're an amazing young man, and I just love the fact that you're so full of joy and so full of happiness and optimism, and it's just so great to see. So the fact that I'm talking about happiness today, and to have this young man that's just so full of life and joy and happiness, you're amazing. Keep up that great work of being an inspiration to all young adults out there. So Shy Noble, you're the man, I love you. Cheers, and thank you for your support. So, and thank you everybody else for your support. That supports me too, I really, really appreciate it. But anyway, happiness. So people often say, Nessie, how do you manage to always be so happy? And I wasn't always happy. Oh my God, tell you, I was not happy. I actually had to find happiness, and I had to create moments of happiness, and then they just did start to snowball, and just happiness started to take over rather than negative and nastiness and horribleness. So yeah, happiness, kindness, all that sort of stuff, it just started to snowball and snowball and get to, ooh, yay, get to great happiness. I love it. So I tell you what, living a sad, miserable existence versus living a happy, bouncy, flourishing life, I mean, it's just, people who aren't living those lives, they get a little bit frustrated, because you can. It's just got to change your mindset really, really, truly. You've got to get rid of those negative thoughts and put in positive ones. But some of the things that I did physically around me to start improving my happiness and to increase my joy and happiness, one of the main things I did, and that's why we're coming from my front entrance today, was I have created a entrance that when I come home from a hard day's work, busy, tired day's work, or just the grocery shopping even, I walk up and there's something there to greet me that makes me smile. So I love nice entrances to your home. Your home, people, where you should feel safe and secure, and you should be full of enjoyment and laughter and tears and anger, all that sort of stuff. I believe that all the emotions that are out there are healthy, and you need to express those emotions at times, but not the sad ones don't stay there. A majority of them should be fun and happy. I'm not happy all the time, and that's why I love my happy places that I've created too. So in those moments of sorrow and sadness and grief, I go to those happy places, places that bring me joy and happiness, and bring me back to where I should be. So yeah, so this is one area, is your entrance, people. Now I have spent very little money creating an entrance here. It's not going to be everybody's cup of tea, but it brings me joy. I love it. When I walk around that corner out of that hot car, up those stairs, and I see this, it makes me smile. And that's the purpose of it there. So also, if I'm not happy, it reminds me to make me smile. And I just love it. So when I walk into home, it's lifted my spirits a little bit, and I really, really love it. It's just a gorgeous old piece of driftwood that we found down the beach. I absolutely love it. Some air plants I stole from my friend's house. Well, she knows I got them. Spreading the love. And this gorgeous thing here, I picked it up on holiday. I mean, it was like $6 something, so it wasn't expensive. Oh, it's Womble. And the mirror had its place in one of my homes, but it doesn't fit in here, so it's now made its home in my front entrance, which I love it. And it only cost me $5 originally from an op shop anyway. But so you're creating a nice entrance to come home to. To set the tone, set the mood, makes me smile, brings me joy. I just love it. And I have pockets of moments around my home and my yard that bring me joy. So this is not the only place, there's lots of little pockets of joy. So at your home, if there's stuff in there that's causing you anxiety, then you need to remove it. It just shouldn't be there. You can't have that type of feeling in your home. If it's mess, generally it'll be big piles of mess. Then you need to deal with it so that you can start finding that happiness and that peace. But you can't find it in huge amounts of mess. I'm not talking about immaculate, keeping it immaculate and tidy. I'm just those things that cause you. There might be a pile somewhere that causes you anxiety, and it really doesn't do you any good to keep it there. So the sooner you can deal with that, then the better you can move on with things. But yeah, so that's one of the things that has increased my happiness. Is just to have things around. I'm not talking about materialistic things that cost it to the earth. Photos of holidays, photos of my family, they bring me joy. I love looking at those sort of things. So that type of thing that brings you joy. I have a big painting of an elephant because I love elephants. Oh my God, I think they're amazing. And that brings me joy. I love those type of things that bring you joy. I'm not talking about big expensive things that you don't need to have around you. They just cause you anxiety because you know you got to pay off the bloomin' HP on it and all that sort of stuff. So I'm not talking about those sort of things that bring you joy. Nice, simple, easy things that bring you joy and happiness. So there's also another tip that I'd like to share with you that I helped increase my happiness. So if I ever got a compliment, it makes you feel really good. And I remember once going in for an X-ray, and this lady paid me an amazing compliment. And I wrote out on the rest of the day on that compliment. I was so up there, and it was at a time when I really, really needed it. And so actually, when I sat down at the end of the day, and I thought, oh, that compliment that lady gave me was so wonderful. And I was so grateful to hear that compliment at that time that I did. And so now I love giving compliments. I love genuine compliments to people. And it just helps, you know, you see them, they might just pick their step up a little bit or lift their head a little bit higher or smile because you've paid them this lovely compliment. And it makes you feel good. So that's another way to increase your happiness. Is to compliment other people, find wonderful things in other people that you can compliment them on, and it does, it lifts your own spirits because you've made somebody feel good and genuine. They need to be genuine, and so that's another way to increase your happiness as well. But one of the most important ones is to have the mindset, you know, stop thinking the negative thoughts and popping in positive thoughts. You've got to tell yourself that you are worthy of doing and being and are. And just keeping those positive thoughts going through your mind. And the minute negative ones come in, you've got to try and squash them in some way. Look at something that makes you smile, and brings you joy and happiness. Some other things are so. I love watching butterflies, you know, monarch butterflies just flittering, fluttering around, and I just absolutely love it. It brings me so much joy, it makes me smile, and it brings me happiness when I see fantails frolicking. So if I need a happiness, I know where I can go walk to find fantails around here. And I just love them. They're just so full of joy and gaiety and happiness, and they just frolic and flitter around. Same with the butterflies. But in the olden days, I'd just see them and go, oh, they're so cute. Now, I just pause and I take a moment when I see things that bring me joy. Anything that you see that brings you joy and makes you smile, stop a moment, and just let it absorb it. Just absorb it in. And just to prolong that happiness and prolong that joy and that pleasure that you're getting from something. And so, and you're just getting more of it and more of it. If making something makes you smile, then stop and try and get as much from it as you can. And then it just grabs hold and everything starts to snowball. You're getting more and more happiness. We just move around this world too fast these days that we just let happiness just pass us by. So stop a minute. And something makes you smile, then just absorb it in. Absorb it in. So good. And then the more that you do that, the more happiness it creates, and then just get happier. You just get happier. You just do. So there you go. As easy as is. And to Shy, much aroha to you guys. Please like, please share, please subscribe, and bring some happiness to some other people out there. Try and go and make somebody happy. Try and find, if you find stuff that makes you happy, absorb it in. Stop, enjoy the moment, take it in. All right, much aroha, bye.